It's a problem that all of us recognize as absolutely horrifying, but what can you do? How can you play a role in stopping human trafficking?
As we learn more about what's considered the fastest growing crime in the world, we are learning that there are steps you can take to help young women find freedom. Mitzi Perdue is the organizer of a global anti-trafficking auction, and she joins us this afternoon on Delmarva Life. Thank you for being here.
What a joy to be back.
Thank you. Wonderful to have you.
Let's first address the problem, human trafficking. It's huge, isn't it?
40 million people. And to put that figure in context, during the entire slave trade of the Atlantic, it was 15 million people.
Wow.
So this is all the horror and misery of the past times almost three.
Who, is there is there a predominant victim? Is there somebody that you
can
describe as being the victim?
Yeah, I can. The traffickers particularly want people who are vulnerable. And that might mean they're in poverty, or they've got a horrible home life, or, you know, one of the biggest sources is runaway children. But then also, okay, I'm talking, this is in the United States, but also in war-torn areas, it flourishes.
Wow, so how does it happen? How does someone become a victim?
You know, there's so many paths to get there, but I'll tell you a typical one. This is a woman, I've talked with many victims of trafficking. I'll give you the example of Mindy Meadows. She's 14 years old, and she came from a very protective, somewhat middle-class family. But one day her parents finally allowed her to go out on her own, and she went to the mall, and she met this really cute guy who told her that he was like just a couple of years older. And he was really interested in her and all her problems with her parents and everything. And they began texting 20 times a day. Mm. And he began pressuring her to have sex with him. And yes, she said, no, I'm a religious girl, I can't do it. But now she's just madly in love, and he said, if you loved me, you'd do it. That was the entryway to being trafficked, because once he had her, it progressed. And she spent 2 years of absolute terror and misery, because if she tried to get away, he told her, I'm gonna kill your baby brother. Or he'd beat her. Or, I mean, she wanted to leave. She was terrified to leave.
That's terrible.
But she didn't think she could. You mentioned war-torn countries. This isn't New York. This isn't L.A. This isn't Dallas-Fort Worth. But it's still happening here on Delmarva.
Absolutely. And we know that because of, for example, life crisis. Or they're just people who know about it.
Yeah.
I have a way of expressing what trafficking's like, and this comes from a psychiatrist friend of mine. He said, imagine the worst depression you've ever been through. Maybe somebody you love died. Maybe you were clinically ill. And there's one good thing about what you've been through, which is there's an end to it. If you're trafficked, it's grinding misery every single day. No end.
Is it likely that we could spot it? I mean, are there any signs that we might see?
In fact, you see them all over, but you don't see them because, or you're not aware of them because somebody has to point them out. And there's a way to find that out. Golly, I hope people have a pencil and paper handy, because I'm going to give an address. It's Polaris, like the North Star, polaris.org.
Mm-hmm.
Unless it's polaris.com, I'm not sure which, but try it.
What we'll do is we'll go ahead and put that on DelmarvaLife.com, and you can find it.
Okay, what they have is a list of 25 red flags or indications of trafficking. And I invite everybody to go there, because once you're aware of that, boy, your life changes. All these things that you saw and never noticed, you notice once you're aware that that's a symptom of trafficking.
Mm.
Been looking at right at all the time, and we didn't realize. Are we ever going to end this? Are we going to be able to stop this?
Well, the United Nations has decreed that it's one of their goals that in 2030 will have wiped out human trafficking. There are 3,000 organizations that are working on it, and I'm working on one right now. It's called the Global Anti-Trafficking Auction, and the point of it is, of all the 3,000 organizations that exist, they could all extend their reach and do a better job if they had more awareness and more funding. And the project that I have, it's the $100 million challenge.
Oh my.
But I think it's doable, because it's in two parts. There's a part that is going to be very attention getting, and very ultra high net worth people are contributing to it. and then there's one for everybody else. The ultra high-end one, the purpose of its being high-end is people can't participate in this unless they put up for auction at the auction that I'm planning for 2021. Mm-hmm. They can't even participate in it unless they have something worth $1 million, appraised at $1 million. And I'll tell you some of the ones that have already come in. There's one, a person has, I guess by inheritance, a necklace that belonged to Marlene Dietrich. And it's,
oh my goodness.
It's huge, perfect sapphire surrounded by diamonds, $1 million. Another person has put up, let's see, one of the world's largest perfect emeralds. Then there's a desk that belonged to a de' Medici cardinal from 1600.
And that's just the beginning.
And another one that I have to tell about because it's such a good story. There's 12 plates that belong to Tsar Alexander II. They were made for the imperial banquet in 1825. And a person has put up all 12 of them. And we already know there's a buyer for them at $1 million because there's a Russian oligarch who wants it.
Well, obviously. Wow. People like us who don't have $1 million can't participate.
But we have room for you.
Yes.
And again, I hope people have pencil and paper out because there's two halves to this. There's the attention getting one, and PBS is doing a story on it. There's newspapers throughout the world who are interested in this. I've even been invited and will go in September to the World Philanthropy Forum to talk about this. So a way of getting attention for trafficking is these very large gifts, including there's a guy in Argentina who may be donating his yacht. But how about for everybody else? There will be on Alibaba and eBay, there will be smaller auctions where you can say, you know, I particularly like, I don't know, the 911, or you can just say where you want your donation to go to, and the internet auctions will make sure that it goes to the place that you say when it sells. And I would like everybody to join, whether they're going to donate something or not. This is a global enterprise. There are people working on it in Canada, in Monaco, in Germany, in Hong Kong, in Taiwan, and in China.
And
it's only, you know, it's only started in April. We need volunteers. And if people, you know, I don't care what your skill is, maybe you're a data cruncher, maybe you're a graphic designer, maybe you're good with a phone bank, whatever it is, come to winthisfight.org. And if I could repeat it.
Well, I tell you what,
we
will put it on our website, delmarvalife.com.
Yeah, because we really want you.
And
I want you. I want you.
Thank you so much for what you're doing.
Thank you.
Yeah.
You are making it happen.
Hopefully you'll come back and give us an update.
Yes.
I would love to.
We would love to.
All right.
Nancy Burdett.